No, I don't know who you are, but you're not Max.
No, there is no such thing as time travel, okay? Because it is against every rule of physics, of reality, of everything.
You're not Max, okay? You're like a shapeshifter. You are like some other kind of alien with like the ability to look like Max with that beard and those gray hairs. Come to me
now. I can show you. I can show you my memories. Lay your hands over me. I need to touch you. Even if it's a lie. Will she forget me?
No, just how she feels about you.
I guess I'm not so special after all.
I am trying to keep you safe.
Fall in love with someone else, Max. I know you're
on to me. Max, you do have a destiny. I can't stand in the way of it.
Nothing has ever mattered to me more than protecting Michael and Isabel until I saw you bleeding.
Do you know how hard it was for me to tell him that I didn't want to die for him?
Everything is gonna be
I may love
you,
think but it ought to be. I don't want to die for like him. Every time I try to make
it was really harsh and cold, and you know, trust me, you didn't want to hear it.
I'm pretty sure I'll remember it. I have loved you my entire life, including every single day. Decade. Open
the door. You gotta come up with another plan. Show me your face tonight. Go to someone else. I can't do this anymore.
Look on his face. On your face.
I lied to you. You're the only one I saved.
What can I do that's gonna make you turn away from me? I turn away.
I'm so
happy tonight. Why don't you explain to me how you understand what I am going through? And I do
believe it's not your fault that I let you down. That's not everything is gonna be the way you think it ought to be. Ever since I healed you, I've felt wrong. Every time I try to make it right, it all comes down to me. I can't fight it. I can't run from it. Honestly, you won't
give up. I really don't think that we should.
Of course, I get it.
I just reread Romeo and Juliet, and you know, the first thing that I realized is that isn't even the title. Hi, Max. It's Liz. It's called The Tragedy of Romeo and Juliet. I'm just scared. They die.
You don't really listen to logic, to what you're supposed to do. You listen to your heart. I promise you, Max, that I am going to take care of it. And what happens to you if we succeed? I mean, you. Yeah, the future version. Then not everything is going to be the way you think it ought to be. Did we get married? Yeah, I know. Like I can't talk about it. I'm sorry.
I am so self-absorbed, only thinking about my future self, myself, honestly, my current present-day self.
And what if it works? I mean, you go off, and what? I mean, what if you never come back? Could you dance with me? I want to have my wedding dance.
Leave the past in the past. You have enough painful memories. How do you truly feel about me?
You're the love of my life. Everyone else is gonna be second best. Be another you.
Right now, what you're feeling is an echo of what I feel for you. But we're off, just like the handprint will.
The heart isn't logical, Liz. Love makes you do crazy things. It makes you do beautiful things and terrible things. Things you'd never do.
I just wish that I could have stopped you from saving my life that day in the crash down.
I am not better off without you. I am not whole without you.
I shall be. I shall believe. I shall believe.
did you believe me when I said I love you?
Yes.
Good. That's what matters. I hope you take that with you wherever you go next. Goodbye, Liz.